Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome to my channel on do-it-yourself home projects. In this video, hopefully provide a practical little tip. You've got a vacuum, I'm sure, and if you want to keep it running for years and years, here's a couple of quick little tips for you. You'd be surprised how much hair is actually collected with carpets. And so here, let's turn it over and take a look here. This is just from about a couple of weeks of buildup. Now we've got four people in our family. Three of them have a healthy set of hair. I am the one who does not. So I am definitely not responsible for any of this. But anyway, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna turn it upside down and very carefully, make sure it's unplugged by the way, make sure all that hair is removed. There's a groove right there in the middle on this particular vacuum. I'm not sure if yours has one, obviously, but we're gonna take a scissors and just very carefully cut along the groove there, making sure we don't damage any of the vacuum cleaner parts. And we're just gonna pull the hair out gently, and that will obviously go into the garbage can. And it does kind of collect, particularly around the bristles. So you'll wanna pay particular attention there to making sure those bristles are generally clean. Now you don't have to have it perfect, right? You can get as deep as you want on this, and it's just going to happen again, I promise you, the next time you vacuum. But this is the idea here. And if you have any, you know, little plastic pieces, little bridges there, you can see I'm carefully cutting behind those. So that's the idea. Pretty simple. We're going to remove all that hair here, and then I'll give you another tip in just a second. So this is kind of what my goal is, looking like that. And you can see, once you turn it on, it frees it up and spins it very freely, and hopefully keeps that motor going for years to come. So next, obviously, we're going to be taking off the filter and taking that out and cleaning that up. And that's a very neglected part of owning a vacuum cleaner, I think. It's obvious to most people that we want to dump it out when it gets full, but how often have you actually cleaned out your vacuum cleaner filter? So you'll want to read the instruction manual on your particular vacuum. This one has a filter that you take out, and then this other little thing, this little trap almost, or flap, that you put in first. So we just take that out, rinse it off, and dry it really well. However your manufacturer suggests that you clean your particular filter. And that is pretty much it. After those two little tricks, I have found that this vacuum cleaner lasts years and years. Now, of course, I can't control for that, but it's pretty common sense. Those two things will maximize the lifespan of your vacuum cleaner. So hopefully this video has been helpful. If it has, do me a favor, click like button, and don't forget to subscribe if you're interested in more videos like this. Thanks.